You're watching UNICEF Television. UNICEF Senior Advisor for Infant and Young Child Nutrition, Dr. Nuné Mangasaryan, discusses the importance of establishing a system to support breastfeeding for Haitian infants.
Before the earthquake, Haiti already was facing serious problems with acute malnourished children. About 10% of them were acutely malnourished, and more than 2% severely acutely malnourished. This is a significant number already, and we expect that due to earthquake, this number will, of course, increase, even maybe double. What does it mean is that we need to really have system in place to especially support this, because this is the group which is especially at high risk of mortality. In situations that Haiti is at this point faced with, the support to breastfeeding is especially of crucial importance. In general, because of all values that breastfeeding has for any child, such as the best composition of all vitamins, minerals, micronutrients, and any nutrients that has the best balance in the breast milk. But in addition to that, of course, it's all other enzymes that allow to have appropriate digestion of this milk. Plus, it's the strong immune system that comes from the mother to the child. All these are especially important in situations like in Haiti, where water, hygiene, and all other important care practices are at risk, and breastfeeding can support and be an important safeguard. What is important that we have organized certain corners or centers or tents, whatever is feasible in the field at this point, to support for a baby feeding support. And this organization will allow to have professional staff, well-trained infant feeding counselors or professional lactation managers to counsel the mothers, to assist them. We have to make sure that the mother is given support, nutritional support, she is given good food, she is given best support, because eventually it's her breast milk that is going to be the best for a baby. Nothing else can really, at this point, replace this. There are different ways to support those babies who lost their mothers and for that reason cannot be breastfed. Of course, replacement feeding is an alternative in this situation, but in situation like in Haiti with water and hygiene problems, definitely we focus and suggest to be more focused on ready-to-use formula, which means that it's not powdered, it doesn't require dilution, additional water to be added, etc. It's ready to feed the child. For that reason, the risk of giving any infections to babies is, of course, lower.
You've been watching UNICEF Television, Unite for Children.